I begin, I would just like to say, anyone named Michael in the crowd, please raise their hand. We got one back there, one there. All right, that concludes our mic check for this afternoon. Welcome, and Jake, thank you for joining us for our 15th annual Community Talent Showcase. I'm Jacob Bertram, and I'll be your MC this afternoon. This event is a sole fundraiser for the care and maintenance of this beautiful facility. And all proceeds this afternoon are invested directly back into this auditorium and arts programming in our community. So in a sense, I hope you all know that you are the heroes in helping those who shine with their talent on and off the stage by attending this afternoon and giving to a worthy cause. The last quote of the slideshow we just watched states that all best heroes are ordinary people who make themselves extraordinary. This truly exemplifies our community. Over and over, we see those around us who reach out to help others in every facet of life. We'd like to thank Gene Lewis for creating our wonderful slideshow. Well, without further ado, it's time to open our show. Representing the Fine Arts Council will be Cheryl Bungham, Gene Lewis, and Nate Rindall performing Holding Out for a Hero.
Street boys came to leaves to go into rock. start the show.
Next, we have Haley Bruhoff taking the stage, which she has done basically her whole life. Most recently, we saw her in the leading role of Sophia in this fall's High School Musical production of Mamma Mia. Haley tells us her biggest cheerleader was her grandpa, because he always supported her love of the arts. Haley cherishes all the memories she has of him. He was with her when she performed a contest for the very first time. Recently, she won Best of Sight by earning a superior rating. Singing is her passion, and she always thinks of him when she sings. Singing and playing, one step forward, three steps back, please welcome Haley. Strand. Hey, wait. Back in 2019, Sophie helped me out with MCing. I wonder how she got out doing it this year. It's like she knows someone on the Fine Arts Council or something. Sophie tells us she learned how to play four mallets on the marimba about 2 weeks before her audition for the Chali School of Music at NDSU. She is now in her third year of the Instrumental Education Program at NDSU. Go Bison and roll herd. Mrs. Strand told me I needed to say that. Since she attended there a few years just before Sophie, only a few years. And yes, she told me to say a few years. Sophie will be performing this song and a couple other tunes on her upcoming junior recital on April 23rd at NDSU. This is a joint recital with her vocal education friend, Tasha Meyer. Sophie currently serves as the president of the marching band and is returning for a second season as a drum major for the Pride of North Dakota, the Gold Star Marching Band. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Let's hear Frogs by Keijo Abe. But I used to play the melodic percussion. I just don't marimba anymore. Our next talented musician is Bob Gardner. Bob has played guitar for 54 years. He tells us his uncle Richard Gardner inspired him to play when he was just 12 years old. The song Bob is singing today is one that Richard himself liked to play. Let's listen to Bob sing and play Ramblin' Boy by Tom Paxton.
I'm not good enough at this to do it by feel. Well, he gave you some introductory material, and The other thing I'd like to tell you is that later on in this program, you're going to meet the two of the three folks who built this guitar. And I cherish it. I like to call it my Stratocaster. If any of you feel inclined to sing along, please do.
He was a man and a friend always. He stuck with me in the hard old days. He never cared if I had no dough. We rambled round in the rain and snow. And here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. In Tulsa town, we chanced to stray. We thought we'd try to work one day. The boss said he had room for one. Says my old pal, we'd rather bum. And here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Late one night in a hobo cab, the weather it was cold and damp. He got the chills and he got them bad. I lost the only friend I had. And here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. He left me here to ramble on. My rambling pal is dead and gone. If when we die, we go somewhere, I'll bet you a dollar he's rambling there. And here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Here's to you, my rambling boy.
Nice job, Bob. That was great. Did you know that a musician told me he was going to hit me with the neck of his guitar? And I replied, is that a fret? I had them put those in just in case somebody would laugh. It's pretty good, actually. Well, we know we don't have to fret about these next act. These young gentlemen are off to a great start in their musical careers. Please welcome to the stage Connor Gunnarsson and Alex Johnson. We saw these gentlemen on stage in their starring lead men's roles in Mamma Mia this past fall. Connor's been playing the guitar for about 6 years now, and he tells us that although Take It Easy usually has simple chords, the second and third chords of the song are very strange and unusual. Well, they sure know how to make it look easy and keep it all in tune. Please welcome Connor and Alex as they will be performing Take It Easy by the Eagles. that's exactly what Sunday afternoons are for, taking it easy. So that's why we're here today. Great job, gentlemen. Oh, here's another joke coming up. What's the difference between a lawnmower and an electric guitar? You can't tune a lawnmower. No, that wasn't something else. That wasn't lawnmower. How do you fix a broken tuba? With a tube of glue. Keep getting better and better. One more. I can't play loud music on any instrument. It's just not my forte. These next groups will be the forte of the show. You're going to keep us in the groove. Time to hear from our instrumentalists. They're mainly freshmen and sophomores in high school. They rehearse a piece for solo and small ensemble contests and receive the high excellence rating. The brass ensemble, consisting of Evan Shrupp, Jasmine Rindall, Taylor Byerworth, and Mr. Nick Flatham. Let's hear these excellent musicians as they perform Happy Tune. Way to go, everyone. We look forward to hearing from you for many years to come. Hey, did you hear about the prison talent show? They had quite the captive audience. This senior ensemble is another ensemble that performed for a solo and small group contest. They were awarded a superior rating for their performance, and they performed Moon Dance by Van Morrison. Moon Dance was released in 1970. It was Van Morrison's first album to sell 1 million records. Morrison fans were known as Vanatics. Not quite certain they'll call themselves that these days, but let's cheer on the senior ensemble, Alyssa Gutwald, Connor Gunnarsson, Alex Johnson, and Kate Landsteiner performing Moon Dance by Van Morrison.
Thank you.
Nice job. I'm guessing by next year they'll be able to play Brown Eyed Girl by Van Morrison too, another fan favorite. So another joke I have for you, you can laugh if you'd like, you don't have to. What do you get when you cross a sweet potato and a jazz musician? A yam session. At least some of you laughed, that's okay. Well, we're ready to yam for this next jazz ensemble. The PAS Jazz Band meets weekly for 30-minute rehearsals and is open to students in grades 9 through 12. They perform approximately 3 performances each year. The Jazz Band also performs for the Solo and Small Group Ensemble contest this year and received a superior rating for their performance. Performing Knockout by Eric Sherburn today will be Connor Gunnarsson, Alex Johnson, Kate Landsteiner, Easton Rindahl, Nick Uhlenkamp, and Mr. Nick Flanagan. That certainly will be a knockout. Let's listen in and see if we're ready. Looks like I have time for another joke, so you're in a treat. What's the most musical part of a chicken? The drumstick. What type of music are balloons afraid of?
Pop.
Pop music. There's smart people in the crowd. Why did the fish make such a good musician? Because he knew his scales. Before they kick me off the stage, I better stop here for a second. We'll tell one more. What kind of music do bunnies like?
Hip-hop.
See? They're catching on a little bit. It's good. Well, I think they're ready to go, so here's Knockout by Ed Sherburn.
Thank you.
certainly was a knockout. Great job, everyone. Let's see. Well, I think it's time to take a break. Give me some time to get better jokes based on your reaction. But we'll be taking our 15-minute intermission. Please take a stroll through the visual arts display located in the hallway and foyer during this time. You'll be amazed at what our students have created. A huge thank you to our talented, creative, and hardworking art teacher, Kelly Whaley. So we'll be back in 15 minutes. Set the second half of the show. Thank you for coming back, and hopefully you had some time to look at the wonderful art displayed in the gallery out there. Not only did Jean Lewis create the fabulous slideshow we viewed today, but she also we also need to extend a special thank you to Jean for many hours of work in writing an application for a Clean Energy Resources Teams grant for the Paynesville Area Schools for Performing Arts Center lighting upgrade. Due to her hard work, we received a CERT seed grant in the amount of $5,000 to help us replace all the lights above the seating area here in the auditorium. The process of replacing the lights will start tomorrow, during the small window of time we have here in the auditorium without any events going on. Thank you, Jean, for giving us a brighter future. You won't need to listen to the fluorescent light bulbs hum anymore. And you know why they hum, don't you? Because they forgot the words. Hey now, I'm just telling some lit jokes. We do seriously want to thank our tech team today because we'd certainly be in the dark without them. They are the unsung heroes of our event and every event. Let's give them a round. Thank you to Logan Armstrong, Katie Good, Adrian Lewis, and Jeremy Schmidt. In addition to those working behind the light and soundboard today, we'd like to thank Colin Wolf. This year, with the change of teaching positions, Colin has mentored some tech students. He's training them on how to run lights and sounds in the auditorium for events, such as the elementary school music programs, the middle school and high school concerts, and homecoming Sweet Fest coordination. His technology help has been greatly appreciated in so many ways. Most of us know, we think we know anyway, everything that goes on in Paynesville. Well, did any of you know that we have gentlemen right here in Paynesville who build their own guitars? Not only do they work on perfecting their craft of playing guitar, but they also create their craft from scratch. That takes these next musicians to a whole new level for their art form. Let's meet Joel Spelzer, who has played since 2010, and Larry Strait, who has played guitar for 40 plus years. But this is the amazing part of their story. They say they both started with very little woodworking skills. We'll let them share their fascinating journey. Let's turn it over to Joe and Larry.
Well, listening to a guy announce this, he just took all our lines away. We have nothing more to say.
Good afternoon.
Yep, good afternoon. Larry Strait and Joel Speldridge. Seeing the size of the crowd here, the word evidently got out that I was going to be playing too. You got any more to say?
That's not it.
You got sound out there?
Yeah.
Really? Okay, so yes, we do build our own guitars. I got into guitars about 40-some years ago and really got hooked on them. They are a pretty amazing instrument, actually. But moved out here over 20 years ago, met Joe, became pretty good friends, and 15 years ago-ish, I went out to the East Coast and built a guitar with somebody who had been building for a long time, a very, master luthier. and it got in my blood, and I came back and I just really couldn't get it out of my head. And it's a very involved process. I did not think I would try to tackle it back here, but I decided that I wanted to, and one day went to Joe and said, what do you think about learning how to make acoustic guitars?
Oh, fine.
Yeah, that was about his response. What the heck, I'm not doing anything else right now. So we ultimately ended up building a whole shop, building a lot of tools, jigs, rigs, things that we, you know, figured out our way to build them, and spent a couple of years doing that, and really had some success and started making acoustic guitars, and ultimately started a business. They're called Crow River Guitars, and we met John Vesner. Actually approached him, who is a Grammy-winning songwriter from Nashville. He's married to Kathy Mattea, and they have a cabin up here. Kathy Mattea is a Grammy-winning country singer, and he ended up really liking the guitars and kind of championed them. And so ultimately, we've got two Grammy winners that play them, country a songwriter, Hall of Fame songwriter that has one of them, a number of local people. So we've had them in shops in Nashville, so we've had some luck. It's been kind of a fun experience. And
yeah, Ryan Upchurch, I've never seen him play a guitar. Yeah. He bought one of ours, and I had to look him up. He's a big-time country rapper.
Yeah, a little new-age country. But anyway, yeah, he bought one out of a guitar store in Nashville.
The other guys play our guitars.
Mm-hmm. We made these guitars. So we're just going to try. The other thing is that when we got into playing or building guitars, I told Joe that if you're going to build guitars, you need to at least know some chords and maybe how to play a little bit. So at the age of, I don't know, 20? No, you were 50-something. 50-something, I started teaching them how to play guitar. And so we've been just kind of having fun with it and jamming, and we get together and play and sing and strum, and you know, nothing, we don't try to do too much too fancy, but have fun with it, and we've been doing that for years. And so what we're going to do today is just play one tune for you, and it's a song I wrote a long time ago. It's called Woke Up on the Wrong Side of Bed. It's kind of based on that character Ziggy from the cartoons who every day doesn't go well. And so it's kind of one of those songs on when you get out of bed in the morning, you kind of wish you hadn't. And, something like that. Alright, here we go. That's you got volume out there with this? I don't hear it here. Okay. Alright, here we go. I woke up on the wrong side of bed. Went to kick the cat and I kicked the dog instead. I went to the kitchen for a cup of Joe, and I turned the corner too soon, I stubbed my toe. Yeah, then I burnt the toast in the toaster, dropped an egg on the floor. Phone rang, I spun around, slipped on the egg, I hit the ground, I said, Lord, thanks for another day, whoa, yeah. Thank you.
is right down the street. Got there, I was late. Going to be another hour wait. Said hello, thanks for another day. Oh yeah, said hello, thanks for another day.
Nice job, gentlemen. Keep a picking and a grinning and gluing and a hammering away. Those guitars look pretty sweet. Well, that's another thank you we'd like to shed today is for our stage crew. So let's give them a round of applause. And as you can see, they're very capable individuals. Okay. Courtney Beavers, Carly Dietrich, Natalie Felling, and Kayla Pinsky have been singing together in Mrs. Bungum's choir through the years. Their love for music has brought these talented young ladies together, and we are ever glad that they are here today to share their talent with us. Please welcome Courtney, Carly, Natalie, and Kayla as they will be singing the fan favorite, Hey There, Delilah.
It's true. Hey there, Delilah, don't you
our capable stage crew gets set for the next scene, I believe I need to tell some piano jokes. You may have heard this one, but why is the piano so hard to open? Because the keys are the inside. What do you call a laughing piano? A Yamaha, ha, ha, ha. Well, I think that concludes my piano jokes. First up, Evan Shrupp, who has been playing piano for a little over 6 years, is our next act. He remembers a Beethoven song being one of the first songs he ever played on the piano. That's pretty awesome to start out with one of the greatest composers of all time. Evan takes lessons from Denise Landsteiner, and he would like to take this time to thank her for investing the time in his skills. Today we hear Evan play River Flows in You by Yaruma. So if we're ready to go, it looks like we are. Here is Evan Shrupp. Young lady started piano lessons when she was in first grade, and now she's a senior about to graduate in a few months. Her piano career has taken her to many competitions where she's earned raving reviews for her accomplishments. Kate would like to acknowledge and thank her piano instructor, Janine Barrett, for helping her progress as a musician. Kate has been a huge asset to our very own music department, and she's accompanied many times to the high school choir. Kate hopes you enjoy this next piece that she learned just for fun as a break from all the classical music she's preparing for her upcoming senior recital. Please welcome Kate Landsteiner to the stage. Kate is going to play Bumblebee Boogie by Jack Fina. Best in your upcoming piano recital and in future endeavors. Well, and our next act in 1962 was when this gentleman started his music career. He's no stranger to our talent showcase venue. This time I'd like to welcome back Terry Nelson and his wife, Deborah. Terry is retired and is doing exactly what he wants to do, and that is perform music. Performing with his wife, Deborah, makes his gig extra special. Terry's heart is as big as the number of songs he can play. You often can find Terry playing at the senior and area and senior care centers, bringing joy to all those who hear him. When Terry plays, every toe starts tapping. Terry will introduce his songs he'll be performing today. So take it away, Terry and Deborah.
This afternoon, the neck was busted off right there. So, I'd like you to give Nathan Rendall a hand because he borrowed me this guitar. I'm going to do a Roger Miller song. If any of you remember who he is. This is from kind of in between when he wasn't drinking and doing drugs anymore. Much. Trailers, save your low rent. Room to live 50 cents. No phone, no pool, no pet. Ain't got no cigarettes. But 2 hours of pushing boom, but ain't the 12-4-bedroom, mama. My enemies by no means king of the road. Third box car, midnight train, destination Bangor, Maine. Old worn out suit and shoes.
Speaking of toes tapping, wait until you see our next group. the Cronus Night Owl Square Dancing Club. Night Owls have been dancing for over 40 years. They have members aging from 9 years old to over 80. Their mission is to promote the growth of modern square dancing by teaching, doing demonstrations at local events, and by just having fun. Cronus Night Owls is a nonprofit who will celebrate 41 years as an organization this September. That's certainly a reason to kick up your heels and celebrate. Well, if they're ready, let's watch them promenade in do-si-do. Here's the Cronus Night Owls.
I also wanted to say we have dancers here from three different organizations. County Line in Monticello, Rockin' Country, that dances in West Union, and the Cronus Night Owls here in Paynesville. Okay, we're ready. Sides face front and square. Well, I was born in a coal miner's daughter.
Just a minute.
Night Owls and the rest of the group that joined. Looks like a lot of fun. Almost like doing a polka dance. Well, I won't need to tell any jokes for her next act, because she tells the best jokes around, or so she thinks. She's been telling jokes publicly for 28 years, but says she's always been funny. And I won't tell you that she's my aunt until after the performance, just in case her jokes aren't the greatest. Please give a warm round of applause to my aunt, Green Leaser.
I'm proud of you, Jacob, that you admitted that. Yeah, I got a call from Matt, and he said, there's people out here that really need some laughs. So I decided I'll give that a try. After hearing Jacob's jokes, I'm glad I came. No offense. He's one of my favorite nephews. The other one's out here. Last year on June, Adrian. I'm gonna have to worry about him today. Last June 12th, my husband Gary and I celebrated our 50th anniversary. Yeah, that was quite humbling. So today I'm gonna share some stories about him, me, us. See if you like them. I came home last week and I got up last week one morning and I said, Gary, last night I dreamt I was at Walmart. Oh, he said, I dreamt I was with three sexy women. Oh, I batted my eyes at him. I said, was I one? He said, no, you were at Walmart. I came home one day and he was standing in the kitchen holding a fly swatter. I said, what are you doing? He said, I'm killing flies. I said, did you get any? He said, yeah, two males, three females. I said, now, how do you know what they are? He said, two were in a can of beer and three were on the phone. You know, everybody's texting these days, and one night I was kind of in a romantic mood, so I texted my husband and I said, text him, if you're sleeping, send me a dream. If you're eating, send me a bite. If you're drinking, send me a sip. If you're laughing, send me a smile. And if you're crying, send me your tears. I love you. He texts back, I'm on the toilet, what should I do? Leave it to a man to screw up a moment. Yeah, last October, we went to a wedding reception. One Friday night, we were invited in Plymouth, and well, we were just gonna go and not stay overnight. Well, just to be safe, I put a few things in the bag, and off we went. We got down there, and there was a little line at the door. We stood in line, and there was two nice couples ahead of us. We had some conversation with them, and when we got in, I was signing the book, and one of the gals came, and she said, would you like to sit with us? We have a table for six. Well, we said, that'd be nice, so we sat with them. We had a couple drinks and we had the dinner and the music started and had a couple drinks and before you knew it, it was midnight. Well, neither one of us wants to drive home and Gary's seen a hotel that was a couple streets down. So we stopped over there. I ran in and I asked the young gal, do you have a room? And she said, we do. I said, how much is it? She said, $75. I said, we'll take it. I took the key off to the room we were in. Right to bed, we were exhausted. Next morning, woke up, I was gonna go down and pay, Gary got the car, and when I got down there, the same gal is still working. So just to be polite, I asked her, so how much for the room last night? And she said, $300. I screamed, $300? Last night you said it was 75. What's the deal? Well, she said, I'm new here, and it's Friday night, I'm sorry. There's extra charges for a Friday night. I said, like what? Well, she said, it's $75 charge for the game room. We have pool, we have foosball, we have darts. We have all kinds of digital games. I said, I don't care what you have, we never used it. Well, she said, ma'am, I'm sorry, but you could have, it was there. She said, $75 charge for the pool, the hot tub, the sauna. I said, we didn't go swimming, we came in late, I told you. We never used it. She said, I'm sorry, ma'am, you could have. It was there. And she said, $75 for the pool, the hot bar, and the entertainment. We had a good band last night. Listen, I said, I don't care if you had the Beatles play. We didn't use that either. Well, she said, ma'am, you don't have to get testy. It was there, you could have. I said, fine. I took the checkbook. I said, I'm writing you a $75 check, and I'm charging you $225 for sleeping with my husband. She screamed. She said, I never slept with your husband. Well, I said, you could have. He was there. We have four sons, and I remember the first time we went out, we left them home. I put some hamburgers and french fries on the table and had to start one of them new bottles of ketchup. Now, you girls especially, remember those glass bottles of ketchup, how hard that was to start those darn things? Oh, yeah, I was pounding the heck out of that trying to get that started when the phone rang. I said to my son, Jamie, get the phone. Well, I soon knew that was a problem. I heard him tell the caller, no, Mom, can't come to the phone right now. She's hitting the bottle. And Scotty was smaller. We couldn't take him along to Palm Sunday Mass because he didn't really sit still, so we left him at the neighbor's. When we came home, went in the house, Gary had brought some palms along for them, so he gave the neighbor the palms, and Scotty said, Dad, what are those? Gary said, those are palms. He said, what did they do with them? Oh, Gary said, they held them over Jesus' head when he walked by. Scotty looked and said, what? I missed one Sunday and he showed up? I thought maybe I should start eating right, so I went to the bakery the other day and I said, do you have anything here with no sugar, no fat? Lady looked at me and she said, the napkins? So I had my wellness test. Checkup a couple weeks ago. And I looked at the doctor and I said, do you think I should eliminate my preservatives, any preservatives from my diet? She looked at me and she said, listen, at your age, you need all the preservatives you can get. But she said, drink four or five glasses of milk. That'll make you strong. You can move a while. Well, I'll tell you, last Saturday night we went out. I drank four glasses of wine. And that wall moved by itself. You know, people say that you're retired, what do you do? And I said, my explanation for retirement is you wake up in the morning, you have nothing to do. And when you go to bed, you're only half done. So I hope you enjoyed the humor a little bit. I think my time's up. Jacob's going to come over here and zap me up or something. So thanks for laughing. I hope you had a good time. And
see you next week. I didn't have much faith in you. I even brought my own laugh sign for the crowd, but I should maybe use that for my jokes, I guess. Well, thanks, Crean. That was a great performance. Now we've almost come to the end of our show.
We have to recognize him as one of our heroes.
Hero, I just say the jokes and just read the script. So thank you everyone else who put this together. But we're almost done with the show, and before we leave, we have guessed that TV theme song, and the winner will receive a brand new car and a trip to Jamaica. Just kidding, I got a little carried away, I guess. That's not the prize. But if you know the next theme song, just shout out the answer. If you're ready, gentlemen, cue the music. Exciting announcement for you all. Here to tell you about it is Jennifer Weirs and Amy Hunter.
Hi, Jen.
Hi, Amy.
Why are you looking so sad?
Well, we just wrapped up the middle school play, and I don't know. I don't really know what I'm going to do next, because, you know, theater is kind of my life, so I don't know.
Hey, have we got a deal for you?
What's that?
The Paynesville Area Community Theater is starting up again after a four-year hiatus. This summer, we will be doing Little House on the Prairie, the musical, July 21st to 24th. Auditions will be held right here on May 24th and 25th at 6:30 p.m. with callbacks on the 26th. Rehearsals will begin on May 31st. Rehearsals will run Monday through Thursday, 6:30 to 9 p.m. The chorus will rehearse approximately two nights a week until we start doing run-throughs towards the end of the rehearsals before the performances. And we are opening it up to six-year-olds and on up through 80. Bring some music with you to perform. We'll have you do a little simple dance step, and we'll have you do some script reading, except for the real young guys. We'll have a special thing for them for auditions. We're encouraging whole families to come together. We have family groups. We can have up to 50 people in the cast. There's about 15 speaking roles, and we'd love to double cast the Ingalls girls, younger in the first act, older in the second act. Hopefully we'll have plenty of kids that want to do that, so.
Oh, but wait a minute. What if you're not into singing, acting, being on stage? Because not everybody's into that.
That's true. We have something for everyone. There are tons of things to do behind the scenes if you don't want to be on stage. There's set building, there's painting of sets, there's publicity, there's ticketing, there's costumes and props, there's ushering. So whatever you want to do, we can find a job for you. And if nothing else, come to the show. We're also planning some great community connections. We're partnering with the Chamber of Commerce for Town and Country Days to do a parade unit and some special activities for kids. We're partnering with the Public Library for a reading program and again some special activities. And we'll also be working with the Paynesville Area Historical Society to have some displays about the history of the area and how people settled this area, similar to the Ingalls and others who went to DeSmet, Iowa, or excuse me, South Dakota. Sorry, it's close. And so we encourage all of you to be a part of it in one way or another. I'll be directing, and Jen will be the producer and stage manager. My name's Amy Hunter, and if you don't like that I'm doing it, you can blame Jennifer, because she's the one that dragged me into it.
All right, hope to see you there this summer. Thank you.
Thank you all.
All right, I have another joke for you to end this evening. What do the musicians say? I'm sorry, what do you say? Wow, I can tell it's the end of the evening. What do you say to a musician playing the triangle in a band? Thank you for everything. Thank you. There's more thank yous for this evening. Helping with the ticket sales today was Jean Verant. Helping with the publicity, it was Miranda Thies. And thank you to the Arts Council members, which include Matt Dickhausen, Cheryl Bungham, Jennifer Wirtz, Nick Flatham, Charlene Strand, Kelly Whaler, Nate Rindell, and Jean Lewis. If you have any ideas or people with talent to share in a talent showcase, please contact any of the Arts Council members. Let's give them a round of hands. Thank you so much for joining us and for being our heroes this evening. You're very capable. So I hope you all had a great time. Jacob Bertram, see you next year, and stay cool, Paynesville. Thank you.